Hello, dear little friends. Welcome to today's English time. Friends, have you finished all the assignments given in the last class? Have you completed? Good. Let's watch some of the completed works done by some of your friends. Let's watch. ഫ്രണ്ട്സ്, ഇതുപോലെയൊക്കെയാണോ നിങ്ങൾ പോസ്റ്റേഴ്സ് തയ്യാറാക്കിയത്? പോസ്റ്റേഴ്സ് എഗെയിൻസ്റ്റ് ട്രീറ്റിംഗ് അനിമൽസ് ക്രൂവലി. ഗുഡ്. ആൻഡ് ഇൻ ദ ലാസ്റ്റ് ക്ലാസ് വി ഹാവ് സീൻ ദാറ്റ് സം പീപ്പിൾ ഇൽ ട്രീറ്റ് അനിമൽസ് ആൻഡ് ബേർഡ്സ്. വി ഹാവ് സീൻ ദ മിസ്ബിഹേവിയർ ഓഫ് ഹ്യൂമൻ ബീയിങ്സ് എഗെയിൻസ്റ്റ് the birds and animals. And for giving awareness to the public, we prepared some posters. Today we are going to see another method, and it is preparing placards. Friends, let's watch some of the placards relevant to the situation. Watch this. Have you seen some placards on that video? Okay. Here are the placards which were seen in that video. These are the placards we have seen in that video. Read this: live and let others live. Don't cage the birds. Animals are our friends. Be kind to them. Animals also have a right to live. These are the placards we have seen in that video. And friends, you have to do a task. You have to prepare placards like these against treating animals cruelly, animals and birds cruelly. We can make these placards and we can give awareness to the public. For that, you can fix these placards on suitable places. You can prepare some placards against treating animals cruelly and fix it in proper places for giving awareness to the public. Ellavarum tayaraakkuvallo? Yes, idupolulla placards for giving awareness to the public about the ill treatment, misbehavior towards the animals and birds. Friends, let's come back to the story of the little wild canary. We have seen that our sparrow put the little bird in a cage, and for the 2 days he gave more care and attention to that little bird. And from the 3rd day he had forgotten all about the little bird. And then his mother remembered him about that little bird. Then only he remembered that. He ran to the cage and he started cleaning it. And while cleaning, he forgot to shut the cage. What happened then? Yes, the little bird flew away. It flew out of the cage and it flew round in the room. Flew around in the room. And then it hit against the window and fell down. It hurt itself. Sarah's mother already told him that, let it go. It will hurt itself. പക്ഷെ അമ്മയുടെ വാക്കുകൾ സെറോ അനുസരിച്ചില്ല. ഇപ്പം എന്തു പറ്റി? ദ ബേർഡ് ഹേർട്ട് ഇറ്റ്സെൽഫ്. ആൻഡ് വാട്ട് ഹാപ്പൻ ടു ദാറ്റ് ലിറ്റിൽ ബേർഡ്? ഈസ് ഇറ്റ് സ്റ്റിൽ അലൈവ്? ലെറ്റ്സ് വാച്ച്. ഫ്രണ്ട്സ്, ഓൾ ഓഫ് യു ടേക്ക് യുവർ ഇംഗ്ലീഷ് ടെക്സ്റ്റ് ബുക്ക്, പേജ് നമ്പർ 151. ദേർ ഇസ് എ പിക്ചർ ഇൻ യുവർ ടെക്സ്റ്റ് ബുക്ക്. ലുക്ക് അറ്റ് ദ പിക്ചർ. What can you see in that picture? Yes, there is a cage and the little bird is in the cage. And what is Sarah doing? Yes, he is holding the cage. And look at his face. Yes, he is weeping, looking at the cage, looking at the little bird. Our Sarah is weeping. Friends, what happened to that little bird? Is it still alive? Let's watch. Let's read the passage. The passage given in textbook page number 151. Let's read the passage and find out. Okay. Are you ready to read? Shall we start reading? Okay, friends. Don't forget to move your finger along the words and lines while reading. എപ്പോൾ പുസ്തകം വായിച്ചാലും വിരൽ വെച്ച് തന്നെ വായിക്കണം. Don't forget that. Okay. Shall we start reading? The sleepless night. Sarah stayed by the cage all day. He did nothing but look at the bird. All the time, the bird lay on its breast, breathing heavily. After Sarah went to bed, the bird died. Sarah could not sleep for a long time. Every time he shut his eyes, he saw the bird gasping and lying still. In the morning, when Sarah went to the cage, he saw the bird lying on its back, stiff with legs crossed. Sarah never caught birds after that. Friends, have you finished reading? Okay. Then, what was the title of the passage? The Sleepless Night. ഇവിടെ ആർക്കാണ് ഉറക്കം നഷ്ടപ്പെട്ടത്? ഉറക്കമില്ലാത്ത രാത്രി, അത് ആരുടേതായിരുന്നു? Yes, it was Sarah's. Sarah's night became sleepless. Why? Why it happened so? Yes, it was because of him. His carelessness, his curiosity to catch birds, cage birds, lead to the death of that little bird, that little wild canary. He realized the fact that his carelessness, his laziness led to the death of that little bird. Friends, what happened on that day? Yes, Sarah was looking at the bird all the time. He waited there for a long time. The bird was lying on the floor with its wings spread out. It couldn't breathe easily. It was gasping. ശ്വാസം എടുക്കാൻ വളരെ പ്രയാസമായിരുന്നു. അനങ്ങാൻ പോലും കഴിഞ്ഞിരുന്നില്ല. പുവർ ലിറ്റിൽ ബേർഡ്. ഹി വെയ്റ്റഡ് ദേർ ഫോർ എ ലോങ് ടൈം. അറ്റ് നൈറ്റ് ഹി വെന്റ് ടു ദ ബെഡ്. ഹി വെന്റ് ടു സ്ലീപ്. അറ്റ് ദാറ്റ് ടൈം ദ ലിറ്റിൽ ബേർഡ് ഡൈഡ്. ബട്ട് സെറോ കുഡിഡ് നോയിറ്റ്. സെറോ ഡിഡിൻ നോയിറ്റ്. He was in his bed, but he couldn't sleep well. Every time he shut his eyes, the little bird was in his mind. He saw the little bird lying on the floor with its wings spread out. The gasping little bird, he felt very sad. He couldn't sleep well. His nights became sleepless. His night became sleepless. At the early morning, he got up and went near the cage. He saw the little bird. It became stiff. The legs were crossed. He knew that the bird was no more. He realized the fact that the bird had died due to his carelessness. After that, he never caught birds. He never tried to trap birds. He never tried to harm any other living things. He taught the lesson. അവൻ പഠിച്ച പാഠം എന്തായിരുന്നു? ബി കൈൻഡ് ടു അതേഴ്സ്. ബി കൈൻഡ് ടു അതർ ലിവിംഗ് ബീയിങ്സ്. ഫ്രണ്ട്സ്, ഹിയർ ദ ലിറ്റിൽ ബോയ് സെറോ, ഹി വാസ് ആൻ ഇന്നസെൻ്റ് ബോയ്. ഹിസ് ഇന്നസെൻ്റ് ക്യൂരിയോസിറ്റി ലെഡ് ടു ദ ഡെത്ത് ഓഫ് ദാറ്റ് ലിറ്റിൽ ബേർഡ്. ഹി ഗോട്ട് ദ birthday gift, the special birthday gift, the bird trap. And he wanted to catch birds using that gift, that trap. His curiosity to catch birds using that trap led to the death of that little bird. അവന്റെ ആ കൗതുകം, ബേർഡിനെ പിടിക്കാനുള്ള താല്പര്യം, അതിന് ഇരയാകേണ്ടി വന്നത്, ബലിയാടാകേണ്ടി വന്നത് ആ ലിറ്റിൽ ബേർഡ് ആയിരുന്നു. ഫ്രം ദാറ്റ് ഓൺവേർഡ്സ് ഹി നെവർ ഹേർട്ട് അതർ ആനിമൽസ് ആൻഡ് ബേർഡ്സ്. ഹി നെവർ ട്രൈ ടു ഹാം അതർ ലിവിംഗ് ബീയിങ്സ്. ഹി ടോട്ട് ദാറ്റ് ലെസൺ. വി ഹാവ് ടു ലവ് അതർ ലിവിംഗ് ബീയിങ്സ് അറൗണ്ട് അസ്. We must love the nature, love other living beings around us. ഈ ഒരു മെസ്സേജ് കൃത്യമായി പകർന്നു തരുന്ന കഥയായിരുന്നു ദ ബേർഡ്, അല്ലേ? ദ സ്റ്റോറി ദ ബേർഡ് ഈസ് ആൻ അഡാപ്റ്റഡ് സ്റ്റോറി ഓഫ് ലിയോ ടോൾസ്റ്റോയ്, ദ ഗ്രേറ്റ് ഇംഗ്ലീഷ് റൈറ്റർ. നമുക്ക് ലിയോ ടോൾസ്റ്റോയ് ഒന്ന് പരിചയപ്പെട്ടാലോ? Let's watch and listen.
Leo Tolstoy was a Russian writer. He is regarded as one of the greatest authors of all time. He was born to a Russian family in 1828. Tolstoy is best known for the novels War and Peace, 1869, and Anna Karenina, 1878.
Friends, ലിയോ ടോൾസ്റ്റോയിയെക്കുറിച്ച് കൂടുതൽ വിവരങ്ങൾ മനസ്സിലാക്കാൻ കഴിഞ്ഞു, അല്ലേ? യെസ്. നൗ വി ആർ ഗോയിങ് ടു മീറ്റ് അനദർ ഗ്രേറ്റ് റൈറ്റർ. ഷീസ് എ ലേഡി ആൻഡ് ഷീസ് ആൻ ആക്ടിവിസ്റ്റ് ടു. ആൻഡ് ഷീ ഈസ് വെരി സ്പെഷ്യൽ ഫോർ ഓൾ ഓഫ് അസ്. അതാരാണെന്ന് അറിയണ്ടേ? എന്തായിരുന്നു ആ സ്പെഷ്യാലിറ്റി? അതും അറിയണ്ടേ? ദൻ ലെറ്റ്സ് വാച്ച് ദിസ്.
സാറാ ജോസഫ ഹിൽ. സാറാ ജോസഫ ഹിൽ വാസ് ആൻ അമേരിക്കൻ റൈറ്റർ, ആക്ടിവിസ്റ്റ് ആൻഡ് an influential editor. She was the author of the famous nursery rhyme Mary Had a Little Lamb. She was born on October 24, 1788.
Mary had a little lamb, little lamb, little lamb. Mary had a little lamb, its fleece was white as snow. And everywhere that Mary went, Mary went, Mary went, everywhere that Mary went, the lamb was sure to go. Mary had a little lamb, little lamb, little lamb. Mary had a little lamb, its fleece was white as snow.
Yes, friends, who was that author? Who was that writer? Yes, Sarah Josepha Hale. She was a famous writer and an activist too. അവരുടെ പ്രത്യേകത എന്തായിരുന്നു? Yes, she was the author of the nursery rhyme Mary had a little lamb. നഴ്സറി ക്ലാസ്സുകളിൽ നമ്മൾ എല്ലാവരും കേട്ടിട്ടുണ്ട്, പഠിച്ചിട്ടുണ്ട്, പാടിയിട്ടുണ്ട് അല്ലേ? Mary had a little lamb എന്ന rhyme. Yes, she was the author of that rhyme. And here is also a poem of Sarah Josepha Hale. And the name of the poem is the same as that of our story. Birds. Friends, let's listen the poem. You please listen carefully.
If ever I see on bush or tree young birds in a pretty nest, I must not in my play steal the birds away to grieve their mother's breast. My mother, I know, would sorrow so. Should I be stolen away, so I'll speak to the birds in my softest words, nor hurt them in my play.
Friends, have you listened the poem? Okay. There's a child in the poem, and she shares her feeling towards the birds. And there are two mothers in the poem. Here mentioned two mothers. There are two mothers in the poem. Can you tell me who are the two mothers? Two mothers in the poem. We have already listened the song, listened the poem. Can you tell me? Who are the two mothers? Okay. The girl shares the feelings of the two mothers, the feelings of love towards their children, of the two mothers. Let's read the poem and find out who are the two mothers. Shall we read the poem? Okay. Birds. If ever I see on bush or tree young birds in a pretty nest, I must not in my play steal the birds away to grieve their mother's breast. My mother, I know, would sorrow so. Should I be stolen away, so I will speak to the birds in my softest words, nor hurt them in my play. Friends, look at the first stanza. If ever I see on bush or tree young birds in a pretty nest, the little girl says, whenever she sees a nest, young birds in a beautiful nest, on bush or tree. She never steal the birds away, the little birds away. She never tried to take away the little birds. Why? It will grieve their mother's breast. It will hurt the feeling of the mother of young birds. In the first stanza, we can see a mother, the mother of young birds, the mother of the bird, young birds, bird mother. We can see the bird mother in the first stanza. The little girl tells, she will never steal the birds away, because it will hurt. It will hurt the feeling of the bird mother. And look at the second stanza. My mother, I know, the little child tells about her mother. Here is the second mother in the poem, the human mother. Here is the bird mother and here is the human mother. She tells, her mother would sorrow so, should I be stolen away. Aa kunjine ammayude aduthu ninnu maatiyalo. Her mother would sorrow. Ammakku sangadavum ile. Ivide bird mother-inte karyam parnathu pole thanne. My mother, I know, would sorrow so, should I be stolen away. So I will speak to the birds in my softest words. So her mother will sorrow. Adugondu thanne young birds inde mother-inodu endu cheyyum? Speak to the birds in my softest words. Valare mrudulamayi, valare snehathodu koodi maatrame birds-inodu polum kutti samsarikkukayullu. Because the mothers, both the mothers have the same feeling towards their children. In my softest words, nor hurt them in my play. She will never try to harm any bird, even in her play. Ee poyathile nammade little child points out the similarity between the two mothers, the bird mother and the human mother. Both have the same feeling of love towards their children. And she never wants to harm them, harm the feeling of the mothers. Shall we read the poem again? Yes. If ever I see on bush or tree young birds in a pretty nest, I must not in my play steal the birds away to grieve their mother's breast. My mother, I know, would sorrow so, should I be stolen away. So I will speak to the birds in my softest words, nor hurt them in my play. She didn't want to hurt them in her play. Friends, we have read the poem. We have seen the feeling, the concern of the little child towards the mothers. One bird mother and the other human mother. And look at the lines. Here are some rhyming words, words having the same sound. Look at the first stanza and you please try to find out the rhyming words. Can you find out rhyming words from the first stanza? Having the same sound. Look at these words, sea and tree. See, tree, both have the same sound. These two are rhyme to each other. And look at this line, I must not in my play steal the birds away, play away. Both the words have the same sound, play away. These two are rhymed to each other. And one more pair. Yes. Nest and breast. These two have the same sounds and rhyme to each other. These two make a pair of rhyming words. And in the first answer, we got three rhyming pairs. This is the first one and this is the second one, and both of this make the third one. Three pairs. Friends, you please go through the second stanza and find out the rhyming words from that stanza. Okay. You can find out the rhyming pairs from the second stanza. It's a task for you. You please go through the lines and find it out. You can copy these rhyming pairs in your notebook. Friends, we have listened the poem, we have read the poem, we have find out the rhyming words, and now it's the time for enjoyment. Let's watch and enjoy the poem.
If ever I see on bush or tree young birds in a pretty nest, I must not in my play steal the birds away to grieve their mother's breast. My mother, I know, would sorrow so. Should I be stolen away, so I'll speak to the birds in my softest words, nor hurt them in my play.
Friends, we have come to the end of this unit. And there are two more activities in your textbook. And the first one is arranging the sentences. And the activity is given in your textbook, page number 155. In that activity, there are some sentences. Kathayil sambhavicha kramathinu ee sentencesgale proper aayittu arrange cheyyanam. You have to arrange them in the proper order. First, you have to read the whole story, the bird, once again. Read it carefully and then arrange the sentences in the right order. Katha nallavannam vaayichu manasilaakki kazhinjal, you can do it very easily. And the next is the portion I can. In that, some situations are given and you have to read that situation and you have to find what did Sero's mother say on that context. Aa situationgalil Sero's amma parna karyangal krithyamayi kandathi ezhuthi kazhinjal, you can light the candles on the birthday cake. You can light the candles on the birthday cake. It is given in the bottom of your textbook. And it is a self-assessment activity. Okay, friends, you please try the portion I can. Friends, we have come to the end of today's class. We have learned a lesson. Don't harm any birds and animals for our curiosity. It's a lesson taught by our little boy Sero. You please always remember that. Okay. Never harm others. And friends, we have come to the end and let's have a look at today's assignments. Okay, dear friends, concentrate on your studies. Stay home, stay safe. Okay, bye-bye.